Kitta, Chief of Army Staff General Qamar Javed Bajwa on Thursday criticized religious seminaries for mostly teaching only Islamic theology, leaving students ill-equipped for life in the modern world. "I am not against madrasas, but we have lost the essence of madrasas," he told a youth conference in Kitta, stressing the country needs to revisit the religious schools concept. The army chief also said that tomorrow's Balochistan will be engine of national development and prove an invaluable link from north to south and also to west. In a double entendre, he said he believes in democracy and even more so in the democratic values of selfless service and supremacy of moral authority. "All of us have a duty to the nation. The country has seen repeated military coups and apprehensions have been expressed by different quarters about General Bajwa's intentions, especially after the disqualification of ex-Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, who believes that army is behind his ouster. Modernizing madrasas, which have mushroomed nationwide, is a thorny issue in Pakistan, where religious schools are often blamed for radicalization of youngsters but are the only education available to millions of poor children." General Bajwa's remarks, apparently off the cuff during a prepared speech, were a rare example of an army chief criticizing the religious seminaries, which are often built adjacent to mosques and underpin Islamization efforts by religious hardliners. General Bajwa said he was recently told that 2.5 million students were being taught in madrasas belonging to the Deobandi School of Thought alone. "So what will they become? Will they become Maulvis, prayer leaders, or they will become terrorists?" Bajwa asked, saying it was impossible to build enough mosques to employ the huge number of madrasa passouts. "We need to look at and revisit the concept of madrasas. We need to give them a worldly education. Pakistan has over 20,000 registered madrasas, though there are believed to be thousands more unregistered ones. Some are single-room schools with a handful of students studying only the Holy Quran. Security services have kept a close eye on madrasas associated with radicalizing youths and feeding recruits to Islamist militant outfits that have killed tens of thousands of people in the South Asian countries since 2000. But only a handful of the schools have been shut down, the authorities, hands stayed by fears of a religious backlash." Bajwa said poor education was holding back the nation of 207 million people, and especially in madrasas. "Most of them are just teaching theology. So what are their chances? What is their future in this country?" The military last year proposed a plan to de-radicalize religious hardliners by mainstreaming some into political parties, a plan initially rejected by the civilian government but which now appears to be taking form. But this policy has suffered a setback as recently capital Islamabad was paralyzed for nearly 3 weeks by a blockade staged by a newly formed ultra-religious party belonging to the otherwise peaceful Sunni Brahvi School of Thought. Pointing to the brighter side of the situation, he said, "Our future is bright and our youth is fully capable of taking on the mantle.